Bear witness as dearly beloved, and watch Renee and Tim declare their love and their faith and their devotion to one another. A wedding is always an especially happy event. It's a hopeful event. Things are right and good, and we are optimistic. These are fast-paced and challenging times, and our days run into months, and our months run into years, and now we get to stop and pause and celebrate with Tim and Renee while they enjoy one of life's greatest moments. As we prepare for this moment, as we anticipate this moment as it's upon us, we feel the pride, the satisfaction, we feel the love. And we also feel just a little twinge of melancholy, a little sense of loss and sadness for those who we wish could be here with us. Would be here if they could. Renee's mom, Sue, Tim's uncle, Rocky, and others. I have little doubt that they are here with us in spirit. I think we can circle back and use that spirit, borrow from it, draw upon it, and make this an even
of two young people, so that together they seem to reach farther into the future than they did before. Above all, marriage is a new task and a new seriousness, a new demand on the strength and generosity of each partner, and a great new danger to both. The point of marriage is not to create a quick commonality by tearing down all boundaries. On the contrary, a good marriage is one in which each partner appoints the other to be the guardian of their solitude, and thus they show each other the greatest possible trust. A merging of two people is an impossibility, and where it seems to exist, it is a hemming in, a mutual consent that robs one party or both parties of their fullest freedom and development. But once the realization is accepted that even between the closest people, infinite distances exist, a marvelous living side by side can grow up for them if they succeed in loving the expanse between them, which gives them the possibility of always seeing each other as a whole and before an immense sky. For the more we are, the richer everything we experience is.
Ruby?
The blessing of the Apaches. Now you will feel no rain, for each of you will be shelter to the other. And now you will feel no cold, for each of you will be warmth to the other. And now there is no more loneliness for you, for each of you will be companion to the other. And now you are two bodies, but there is only one life before you. May your days be good and long upon the earth.
Logan?
Love is friendship caught fire. It is quiet, mutual confidence, sharing, and forgiving. It is loyalty through good and bad times. It settles for less than perfection and makes allowances for human weaknesses. Love is content with the present, hopes for the future, and does not brood over the past. It is day in, day out chronicles of irritations, problems, compromises, small disappointments, big victories, and working towards common goals. If you have love in your life, it can make up for a great many things you lack. If you do not have it, no matter what else there is, it is not enough.
Julie. That was beautiful.
So now we're set to exchange the vows. First, Renee will have some vows that she will offer, and then Tim, and then I'll have some vows that they will repeat.
Tim, you're my best friend. I'm the love of my life. I love you so much. Not only for the amazing man you are, but for who I am when I'm with you. I love waking up next to you every day, walking out of the house with our morning coffee, and sitting in the backyard for our evening glass of wine. I love you and the life we've built together. I promise to encourage and inspire you, to laugh with you, to comfort you in times of sorrow and struggle. I promise to love you in good times and in bad, when life seems easy and when it is hard, when our love is simple and when it is an effort. I promise to cherish you and to always hold you in the highest regard. I promise to fill your days with sunshine, to support and encourage you, and to try and stay out late on Fridays with you once in a while. I promise to ask you for help when I need it, to speak up more often, and take the time to sit down and talk through things when you need to. I promise to answer my cell phone more often. Not for everyone, but certainly for you. I promise to be a good mother to our children, and I promise to always be there for you, as you have so steadfastly been there for me. I promise to help you reach your goals, to stand together always, and to be your best friend. I promise to love you for all of my life, with all of my heart.
There you have it.
Renee, I love you. I've loved you for a very long time. Although you did not know it. I knew that I loved you the first time I saw you, with your cool white eyebrow stripe, holding your clarinet, wearing a blue polyester marching band uniform, dancing the boogie down. And now, after many years, you are my best friend and the love of my life. I promise to encourage and inspire you, to laugh with you, and to comfort you in times of sorrow and struggle. I promise to love you in good times and in bad, when life seems easy and when it is hard, when our love is simple, and when it is an effort. I promise to cherish you, and to always hold you in the highest regard. I promise to be there for you when you need me, to fill your days with sunshine and to support and encourage you. I promise to say I love you at least once, each and every day. I also promise to crack your back when it's all jacked up, whenever you need it. I promise to not look for protection in you, and to cultivate flexibility, patience, and understanding. I promise to help you reach your goals, to stand together with you and face the world, and to be your best friend. I promise to love you all my life with all my heart.
So there you go.
Renee, do you go to share the joy of life and give her the trust of all your tomorrows?
I do.
So, having spoken their vows, we're going to exchange the rings, and we have the rings nearby, I'm told. And these rings are the symbol for all time of the vows you've just spoken. They are the outward and visible sign of the unique and special love that only you know and share. As they are the finest of materials on earth, so your love is the richest of spiritual values. And we have a blessing of the hands, still giving you the same unspoken tenderness with just a touch. So, Tim, Please repeat after me. Renee, I give you this ring as a pledge of my loyalty and affection.
Renee, I give you this ring as a pledge of my loyalty and affection.
There we go. And Renee, after me, please. Tim, I give you this ring as a pledge of my loyalty and affection.
Tim, I give you this ring as a pledge of my loyalty.
Well, having exchanged their vows and exchanged these rings, by the authority vested in me, I'm happy to declare Tim and Renee husband and wife. And Tim, you may kiss the bride. And I'm delighted to present Mr. and Mrs. Timothy Stone.
Thank you. can't say enough about it. So with that, I think we're going to turn it over to a few folks who are going to be doing some toasts. Roasts.
That was last night.
So I think first off, we've got Mary Vanderweel. Many of you know, many of you I know, some I don't yet, but it's clear that Renee and Tim are blessed with an amazing support system of friends and family. That being said, for those of you who may not know me, I'm Mary, one of Renee's younger sisters. Because of all of you, Renee has many nicknames. Nay, Renee, Renee Vanderweely, Spoon, Spooner, Spoons, even Renee Vanderstrand or Strander Wheel. The list goes on, but growing up, I called her Queen Bee. At that time, it probably wasn't meant to be the most loving name. But looking back, I guess when there are five kids, someone has to control a remote, dominate the bathroom, and tell everyone what to do. Being the oldest of five is undoubtedly a hard job. And without her realizing it, she has influenced my life in more ways than she'll ever know. Everything Renee did, I wanted to do. From ballet classes and playing soccer, to playing the clarinet, waitressing at Roses in Eastern Rapids, going to U of M for undergrad, and even moving out to the Pacific Northwest. Renee has been there. Whether it was applying for school or prepping for a new job, Renee is always the first one I turn to. I cannot begin to tell you how fortunate I am for having such an amazing older sister and role model. Who else sends you cards out of the blue just to tell you that they're lucky not to? Who lets you crash on your couch for an entire summer without paying rent? And who drives from Ann Arbor to Grand Rapids at the drop of a hat just to get their sister out of trouble? Although I still don't think mom and dad know. I cannot begin. Having such a great sibling like Renee makes you very protective of them, especially when it comes to dating. So I needed a little more information when I received a phone call that Renee had just kissed a boy that she had gone to prom with almost a decade earlier. The investigation began. I learned that Renee and Tim sort of lived parallel lives, only a few years apart from each other. They both grew up in EGR, both were in the marching band, they both went to U of M for undergrad, both majored in architecture, both moved out to Colorado, both went to grad school for architecture, both lived on the West Coast. It was a little creepy. For, you know, 10 years, they kind of went their separate ways, and one weekend back in Grand Rapids, they reunited, and here we are today. So I have to admit I was a little skeptical of Tim at first. Let's be honest, the queen bee needs a king of a man. However, I had the pleasure of really getting to know Tim the last couple years when we lived out here in Seattle. Tim is goofy, creative, incredibly smart, always considerate, and most importantly, it's clear that he is a truly loving partner for Renee. Renee, thank you for everything over the years. Tim, couldn't be happier to have you as part of our family. I love you both so much, and I'm so excited for you guys to start this new chapter of your lives together. And with that, please join me and raise your glasses to the new bride and groom, the Vanderstrands.
After such great, first of all, I want to say, wow, what an incredible day, what an incredible couple, what an incredible step setting. What an incredible words of love and four vows. It was totally incredible. And I am so pleased and so proud and so happy for this day. This is really the best. Well, after the words before me tonight and what happened a couple nights ago with Thursday night's excellent accolades for Tim and Renee, I kind of feel up here tonight like Elizabeth Taylor's seventh husband, Larry Kordensky, on the night of their wedding. I basically know what's expected of me, but I'll be darned if I can figure out how to make it interesting or exciting. So what I've come up with is something that kind of tees off a little bit with what Mary said and the Honorable John today. This is information only. This is not advice. There's a big difference between the two. So I wish Tim and Renee to use this and enjoy this and benefit from this. It has to do with communication, which perhaps is the most important aspect of a relationship. And since we're here tonight honoring Tim and Renee and their new relationship, I thought I'd share a few thoughts on this with you. We communicate to others in different ways. For those romantically involved, the form of communication to explore here tonight is the kiss. There are several different forms of communication, and there are many forms of a kiss with many reasons for it. Let's here now get the record straight. Let's exclude all forms of and reasons for a kiss except for those of a romantic kiss on the lips, symbolic of a good expression, a physical expression of affection and love. What's involved? Why does it feel so good? Is there anything to know about this besides just the obvious? First, let's get to the downside of kissing on the lips. You have to know, for health reasons, this is not totally innocuous. Be aware that kissing in this fashion exposes the participants to saliva, one of our bodily fluids, which can result in disease transmission, like mono, herpes, and others. Not to mention, doing this in public, in certain countries where public display of affection is forbidden and even unlawful, this can result in very serious consequences. So let's get that part put away and get to the information's part of this and the feel-good part. Any Google can reveal that a serious romantic kiss is a complex behavior requiring coordination of 34 facial muscles and 112 postural muscles. The dominant facial muscle is known as the orbicularis oris, which is used to pucker the lips and is informally known as the kissing muscle. When romantic partners contact each other's lips, which are highly innervated sensory structures, the sensation of touch, taste, and smell are all involved. Actually, brain scans have shown that in each partner's brain, the ventral tegmental area, called the VTA, we'll just call it tonight the lobe center, is flooded with a neurochemical called dopamine. This is true, which has been shown to be liberated when one is doing something highly pleasurable. So Tim, please tell the hostess at this time to serve dopamine cocktails. Okay, besides the obvious pleasure benefit, romantic kisses have actual health benefits. They reduce stress, They increase relationship satisfaction. They even have been found to reduce cholesterol. They also release epinephrine and norepinephrine, from the adrenal glands into the bloodstream, causing the heart to beat faster, which has certain cardiovascular benefits. One investigator even found romantic kissing can burn up to 2 to 3 calories a minute. Get to work. To summarize with words found in those of Richard Lyle Allen and How Green Was My Pasture, I dedicate this to Tim and Renee.
Oh.
It is called The Kiss. There is strange and yet not strange is the kiss. It is strange because it mixes stillness with tragedy, and yet not strange because there is good reason for it. There is shaking by the hand. That should be enough. Yet shaking the hands is not enough to give in to all kinds of feeling. The hand is too hard, too used to doing all things. With too little feeling and too far from the organs of taste and smell, and too far from the brain, and the length of arm from the heart. To rub a nose, like some, that we think is so silly, is better, but there's nothing good to taste about the nose. It's only an old piece of bone pushing up the face, and a nuisance in winter, but a friend before meals, and in the garden indeed. With the eyes, we can do nothing. For if we come too near, they go crossed, and everything comes twice to the sight without good from one or the other. There's nothing to be done with the ear. So back we come to the mouth. And we kiss with the mouth because it's part of the head and the organs of taste and smell. It is the temple of the voice, the keeper of the breath and its giving out, the treasurer of tastes and succulences, and home of the noble tongue. Its portals are firm, yet soft, with a warmth and a ripeness unlike the rest of the face, rosy, and in women, with a crinkling red tenderness, not to the taste, and compare with a wild strawberry. Yet if tastes of kisses went, and strawberries came the year round, half the joy would be gone from the world. There is no wonder to me that we kiss, for when mouth comes to mouth, in all its stillness, breath joins breath, taste joins taste, warmth is in warmth, and tongues commune in a soundless language, and those things are said that cannot find a shape, have a name, or know a life in the pitiful faults of speech. To Tim and Renee, all.
Because I love them both. The problem there is that these would be no material. We're kind of just figuring this one out as we go along at this point. Timmy and I went to elementary school together. We went to junior high together. We went to high school together. We went to college together. In college, we lived together. After college, we moved 2,000 miles apart for a few years. But ever since then, we've slowly been moving back together. Again, back to the whole idea of keeping us on the up and up, I'm gonna skip the part about prank calls where we have made arrangements for all the first graders to go over to each other's houses and create chaos. That's not cool. I'm gonna not talk about the time when Tim and Gray and I, Gray's here somewhere, we're not gonna talk about when we went to Napa after the whole long unshowered weekend and decided to go wine tasting with flip-flops and dirty shirts and 3 guys spilling out of a car, and everybody in the tasting rooms kept telling us that they were closing. talk about when we painted the summer that Timmy and I painted houses together and painted an unventilated basement. And by the time the boss showed up at the end of the day, the two of us were rolling around in the front yard giggling because we didn't nail some meters. Yeah, not really a whole lot left to talk about. I think that what I would like to focus on more is just maybe say something to Renee, which is, Renee, I love you dearly. I remember the time when I was there at band camp, and our sophomore year, and Timmy told me that that hot Dutch chick was his friend. I don't know if it's fair to talk about the time that we were also there, all hanging out together, Thanksgiving weekend, 5 or 6 years ago, and we were all back in town in Grand Rapids. Timmy and our other friends Tom and I decided to go out for beers, and Renee was there and came along, and we all had a great time. We were about 28 or 29. I haven't done the math on any of this, so don't worry about it. At the end of the night, my lovely wife Genevieve, who's here tonight, was peacefully sleeping in the basement. My dad was sleeping in the bedroom, a little ways down the hall, and we were acting like, 19-year-olds, booming around the kitchen and drinking beers and giggling and making asses of ourselves and just, trying not to wake everybody up. Had a great time. Thought I don't know when I'll see Renee again, but it was good to catch up with her. And it wasn't until the next morning that I found out that was also the evening that this phase of their relationship began. So feeling like I've really stuck my nose in their business way too much as it is already. Maybe we should just tag out for a while and we'll talk in 10 years. But I don't think that's going to happen. My wife and I moved across the country and live out here now, partly so that we could be closer to these guys. We love them dearly. And I'm not kidding about that. What I want to say about them both is that, Renee, I would like to apologize for being a terrible, terrible influence on Tim for the last 34 years. I would really like to apologize for that. I'm just not sorry about it. So. I don't know where that leaves us, but I would like to apologize. The last thing that I want to say we're gonna get a little bit real here. All silliness aside, I've really admired both of these two for their levels of thoughtfulness, their drive, their determination in everything they do. We do a lot of stuff that has no logical explanation, but in their work, in their lives, in their relationships, the amount of caring that both of these two express is extremely rare. It's awesome. Timmy, you're my brother, you're my best friend, you deserve everything the good that you get, and Renee is that. Renee, I've had 34 years with him, and we're not done. It's truly, truly exhausting. Really tired. But it's worth every minute. That's all I have to say. I don't have a
good evening. It's nice to show. Hello, everyone. I'm Tim's brother, Dave. It's been a long time coming for me. I thought about what I'm going to say here a number of times. We'll see how it goes. But what an incredible afternoon and last couple days it's been. I've never seen such a genuine outpouring of vows, emotions, love, and I was truly honored to be up there with you today. Thank you, both of you. Mary and I are on the floor. Ron, I think we have a little more water than the rest of you, but it was that good. So I feel obligated, I need to just maybe clear up any misconceptions that some of you may have for whatever reason, maybe because I maybe told you something, but I'm in fact Tim's old. You don't know, right? So it's not bad. But I say that because with being Tim's older brother, came some, I don't know, responsibility, or just maybe not responsibility, more of just a keen level of interest. So you might think, so I'm, Tim, 7 years. That's a lot. Not now, but when you're kids, it's a lot. At least 5 years older. And so some might say, oh, the youngest of three, you might have to prove yourself or go the extra mile to get the attention. Not the case with Tim. And for a number of reasons, Tim, first off, is pretty much good at everything he ever did, right? So he's artistic, musically talented, he's kind, loving, he's got great grades, you name him, he's got it. But the thing with growing up with Tim was, and this was talking a little bit last week, the other night, but he was incredibly cute as a kid. You couldn't get past it. I mean, ridiculously cute. The sailor suit, you know, he's Tim. And he wore it way too much. Right. So, like I said, so 7 years, high school. We're in sort of different phases in our life a lot, but we always were able to kind of come back, after I left for college and reconnect, and it was great. But I'll tell you, the amazing thing was, maybe after college, that's in high school, and I come home, and I hear, just somebody wailing on a drum set downstairs. And I go, and my mom's up there, and just kind of going with it, and I said, what is that? She's like, that's your brother Tim. I'm like, I play the drums. Tim has drums, and my mom says, well, you have drums, dude. Tim plays it. And it was true, amazing, so here was this, I'm skipping ahead, here was this cute, squishy little kid that all of a sudden turned into this bright, artistic, articulate, smart man. And it's been such a pleasure in my life to have him in like that. Like I said, I was on here today, and I'm hoping I'm doing you justice tonight. Tim. I love Renee. 8 hours after I met her. Renee, they had a, 2005 Thanksgiving? Yep. Had a little, I heard, Tim was coming down. Tim was up in the Rapids. We were in Buffalo with Jill and Rocky. And they came down. We had a night out. Social was fun. Great vibes. But, like I said, older brother. Don't know. Girlfriend or two attempts, maybe, all very nice people, so I have to check it out, right? So we have a good time. I get up in the morning, they've crashed out. Looks like they sat up all night talking and just fell asleep where they lay out on the entryway of one of the upstairs bedrooms, just kind of right out in the middle. So I get out and I said, all right, I gotta do something here. What can I do to test the salt, the grit that Renee has? So I thought, that perfect thing. In my possession, 20 feet away, I possess a 3-month-old little girl in diapers, ready to go. So I turn around, go back in the room, go pick up the Wiggly Wonder, diapers, ready to get up. And I walk out there, and with the intention to plop her down, which I do, and say something, meaningful and insightful, you guys keep this up, you're going to end up with one of these. But before I can get it out, Before I could say that, I plop her down. Renee is in a dead sleep, and she's just, oh my goodness! She just does the baby cage around her back out, and Tim, one arm. So now she's in there in a 3-arm trap. past, and whatever I've tried to say or thought I was going to say, I didn't. That was, of course, before I really knew her and how immediately wonderful she is with children, which she is, and just a host of other qualities. I think you two are, I'm so happy to see this, I think you two are truly meant for each other. You complement each other. You're both so artistic, and you have similar tastes, you believe the same things, a host of other things. I have lots of stories about Tim, and fewer about Renee. Johnny, Kat, Mary, and Paul, it's been a pleasure getting to know you. I look forward to spending more time with you and your extended significant others, Logan, everybody. Yeah, like I said, I have a bunch of stories about Tim. But they all kind of end the same way for me, it's a problem. So he's a heck of a guy. You do good to Renee. You do good to Tim.
Yeah.